I'm going to talk about getting a calf crush from the reverse scarf hold. All right, now I'm going to set up. I'm going to set this up a little bit differently than I've been working with from this position. Normally, when I have a reverse scarf hold, I'm above this shoulder, and working here. This time, I'm going to bring my elbow underneath his armpit because that's going to give me a little bit closer to his foot as opposed to coming from here where he may be able to block me from catching his foot when it's time for me to go. So I'm going to start here underneath his armpit. So I have my position. I'm tight in my position. Got my chest down. I'm going to take my leg. I'm going to throw it over his leg. I'm going to overhook his leg. When I do that, this knee's going to go to the floor, to here. Now once it comes here, I'm going to reach down. I'm going to grab his toes and pull them in. Now what I was saying about my arm being closer, all I'm going to do is reach around his leg. I'm going to grab his toes and I'm going to pull them in. As I pull them in, I'm going to kick my leg out and apply pressure to his calf. So as I'm here, grabbing the toes, and grab the toes too. You're going to get a lot more leverage by grabbing the toes than if you grab his shin or even the foot, the top of his foot. I'm going to grab his toes because I can control his foot a lot more, his whole leg a lot more from this position. I'm going to pull it in towards his butt as I kick my shin onto his calves. Now, full speed. One of my favorite techniques. You know, I love to do these little tricky techniques, these little sneaky techniques that these guys can't never really see coming. All right, I'm in the reverse scarf hold position here, holding him down tight. He's trying to push my face away. The first thing I do for him to put when he's pushing my face away is I can't let him extend me back here. So I do want to lean in and keep my weight down. Now I'm going to slide my hand and palm up. I don't want to come in like this because my hand may be too big, so I'm just going to sneak it in this way. Sneak it in the palm up. Now, I'm going to raise my hips and lean on top of his wrist. Put all my weight on this part of his arm here. Now, once I do that, I'm going to make a fist and turn it here. I love this move. Watch this. Yeah, you see? I love doing that to guys, so I put it in, turn, and put pressure down. Very painful. Now let's do it at full speed. All right, we're gonna work on this hip lock from the reverse scarf hold. I'm starting off from a very solid position, legs spread in a strong base, got his head covered nice and tight. He's got his leg up. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get control of his leg. I'm gonna come behind his leg and pull it towards me a little bit. Now, after I pull it towards me, I wanna run him that way so I can keep him flat on the floor. So I'm gonna start to move his body this way. As I move his body this way, I'm going to just separate his legs as much as I can so that it makes it an easier access for me to get my leg over his far leg. So I'm going to turn him a little bit this way, separate his legs. Now I'm going to throw my leg over deep into his far leg, and I'm going to hook it. Now from here, I'm going to pinch it back. Once I pinch it back, I'm going to take my elbow and I'm going to pinch his head towards his legs. Now from here, I'm going to run this top leg. I still have it hooked. I'm going to push that way as I push my hips forward and pull my legs back. And I'm going to pressure. And that separates his hip joint here and it puts a lot of pressure on his other hip. It's just a terrible, terrible position to be in. I would hate to be this guy right now. That's why I'm going to give him another little push. Oh, that sucked. Now, in full speed, guys, let me show you how it's done. We are going to take a look at this technique here. This is going to be your basic Kimura from a reverse scarfold. I'm going to start my reverse scarfold here. Nice stable position. I want my weight forward over his body, covering his head so he can't see what's going on down here. Now for him, this arm is totally exposed. So, you know, most guys will try to put it under the armpit to have that underhook. That's okay. Because all I'm going to do is I'm going to lean back without going back too far. I'm just going to lean back just a little bit to grab the wrist. As I do that, I'm going to come over the shoulder and I'm going to put my weight, use all my weight and put it to the floor. Put his arm on the floor. Now I'm going to shift my hips, turn my hips the other way, this way, and I'm going to lean back. I want his arm at 90 degrees. All right. So that you guys can see, I'm grabbing his wrist here. I'm over his shoulder. I figure four of my arms. Now I'm going to lean back the other way. Got his arm at 90 degrees. I'm going to pull his elbow towards me and push his wrist towards his head. So as I start here, and he's got that underhook, I'm going to come over the top, change my weight, put it to the floor first, shift my hips. Remember, 90 degrees on the arm and get the submission. Now, let's do it in full speed. Alright guys, let's talk about how to get this knee bar, how to set it up, how to finish it, how to make it work for you, how you're going to add it in your game, how you're going to be submitting everybody in the gym with this position. Alright, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start from my reverse scarfold position. I'm here, my base is wide, so on and so forth. Now, I can get him to get this leg up. How? I can tease him with going to mount. It's going to be easy for me to mount him, so that's going to get him to get this leg up to keep me from mountain. So once this happens, I'm going to grab his leg and hold it up. Now once I have his leg held in position, I'm going to get my knee in here. So if you can see, I'm just going to put my shin all the way across his hip line, nice and tight, while I hold his leg. So he gets his leg up, I'm going to come in nice and tight here. Now I'm going to control his leg here. If I don't control his leg, he may kick it out. So in order to help control his leg, I'm going to grab my knee. If you can see here, I'm locked around and I'm going to grab my knee here. His leg is coming out here, so I'm scooping his leg, holding on to my knee. So I'm in this position, got his leg, and I'm going to hold on to my knee. Now from here, I'm gonna shoot this leg inside and hook his leg. Let me turn so you guys can see this. Just right there. Here's where we want it. Now I'm here, holding on to my knee, you can see. I'm gonna shoot this leg inside and I'm gonna lock onto his leg here. Now from here, all mine. I'm gonna lean over to the side. I'm gonna grab his heel. I'm gonna squeeze my knees. I'm going to attach his heel to my ear, and I'm going to push my hips forward, and I'm going to finish with the knee bar. The important thing is that I'm controlling his leg. When I get here, and I have this shin across his hip, I'm holding here, grab here, this comes inside, I'm going to fall to the side. I'm going to grab his heels, I fall to the side. Put it on my ear, lock it down, and push my hips forward. Make sure you keep your knees tight, you squeeze your knees, and you push your hips forward. Let's do it in full speed. I'm working from the position now. I'm gonna give you guys a modified Kimura. This one's very painful, and it looks a lot cooler than your traditional Kimura. So add this in your book. Okay, so I'm gonna start from my reverse scarf hold position. I'm nice and tight, nice and low, covering his head. He's looking to get this unbroken. I'm gonna reach back, grab his wrist, and put it back to the floor. Now this time, once I get it to the floor, I'm gonna hold it. I'm gonna trap his wrist to the floor behind his back. Now from here, what a lot of guys are going to do is they're going to start to turn and start to buck to try to get their hips out to alleviate that pressure that's on his shoulder. But what I'm going to do to stop that pressure from coming is I'm going to put my knee on his hip and grab his leg here. This is going to keep him from being able to turn too far in and scoot his hips out. So I'm going to grab his leg and put my knee right inside his hip here and put pressure here. So I'm going to start pulling on his leg and keeping his hips still using my knee here. Holding. Now from here, I'm just going to lean back and extend his shoulder that way as I pull his hand towards his back. So I'm holding here, keeping his tight, putting pressure, using my hip on the knee, putting pressure on his hip this way. Extend his, push his shoulder out as I push his hand towards his back. Get the finish. Now full speed. I am starting from the reverse scarf hold position, and I am going to choke him silly from here. If he's going to tap, I'm going to choke him silly and put a lot of pressure on his neck. Okay, I start in my reverse scarf hold, knee close to the hip, my arm past his head, base wide, I'm here. Now for him to escape, he's going to try to get out, he's going to try to escape his hips and turn into me, and he's going to lift his head up just a little bit. When I feel him lift his head up a little bit, I'm gonna wrap my arm around his neck. So I take my arm, wrap it all the way around his neck here, and expose my hand to the inside of my stomach. So I come all the way around here. Once I get here, I lock my hand. So let me turn a little bit. You guys can see this. I'm gonna all the way around his head and lock my hands here. Now when I lock my hands, I'm gonna pinch his head down with my elbow inside my rib and crunch here. So I start, he turns and lifts his head. I come, expose my hand, I lock my hands. I pinch his head into my rib using my elbow. Now to keep him from turning into me further, I'm gonna put this knee on top of his hip and drive forward using my leg. I'm gonna drive him back down, lock my hands, and squeeze. So, this way. Let me do it in fast motion. This is called a squeeze lock Or it's very similar to a calf crush. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to set this up the same way that I'm going to set up a knee bar. I'm starting off from my modified scarf hold position, keeping my knee tight up against his hip. I have good pressure on his head, on his chest. He brings his leg up to keep me from mounting. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab his leg, and I'm going to get my shin and my knee in position. Coming nice and tight here. Holding his leg. Now, I'm going to grab my leg. So, from that position on the inside, I got my knee. This knee and this shin is up against his hip. I'm going to overhook his leg, and I'm going to grab my knee just like this. All right. I'm here. Grab my knee here. Now, he may know that I'm going to go for the knee bar and may try to bring his leg down. That's even better for me. If not, I'm just going to reach up and grab his toes and pull him down. Pull his toes down. Now, from here, as I pull his toes down, I'm going to throw my leg over top of his shin here, and I'm going to put it underneath my wrist. Extra pressure. Now, with my fist, once I have it under there, I'm going to twist my fist like this, because right now, this flat part is up against his calf and his hamstring. But when I twist it, it's going to put the blades up against his calf and his hamstring, which is going to cause a lot of pressure. It's going to cut right through the muscle. So I'm here. I'm pushing his leg down this way. Holding on to my knee. I'm going to throw this over the top here, and I'm going to press down as I turn my fist up. You see, I'm going to turn my fist up. Put a lot of pressure on his calf and hamstring. And get my squeeze lock. Give you guys another angle. If you can see. Here, holding on to my knee. Pulling it down. This is going to go over the top. I'm going to put it right underneath my wrist. My toes underneath my wrist. Come here and twist my fist. As you can see, twisting my fist up here as I'm pushing down. Now, let's do this in full speed so you guys get an idea of how it looks in real life. Now we're going to do a toe hold from the modified, not the modified, but the reverse scarf hold. All right, I'm starting my position. I'm controlling his head here, pinching it back, got a nice wide base. And what's going to happen is he's going to bring his leg up. That's going to, you know, maybe block me from going to the mounted position, but who cares? Who cares if he blocks me from going to the mounted position when I can get him in a toe hold? So I'm going to start here. I'm going to hold his leg. Now, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get closer to him. I'm going to put my shin along his hip line, knee up. I'm going to hold his leg here. To control his leg, if I need to control it even further, I'm just going to put my hand on my knee. I'm going to get a lot of leverage, a lot of strength by putting my hand on my knee to control his leg here. Now, I'm going to reach up. I'm going to grab his toes. Not at the instep, but at the toes here. I'm going to pull them down. Then I'm going to figure four my arms. Now, normally what will happen is if I just try to finish like this, he'll take his other foot and kick my hands off. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my outside foot and hook his leg here. It's going to keep him from using that leg to block my toe hold. And if he starts to move it, I just follow his leg. By the time he gets it off, I finish the lock. I finish the toe hold. So use your other foot to lock down his leg as you apply pressure with the toe hold. Now, in order to get the finish with the toe hold, I'm going to turn his toes down in a way my wrist is going to push up. So the motion is down and up on the foot. So when I have it here, I'm going down and up. Now, in full speed.